In today's video, we're going to create a really neat looking cluster column chart in Excel that's overlaying another bar chart. What kind of? The idea for this video comes from Raza, who asked, can you do a YouTube video to make the above graph with the same formatting? Here's the graph. It comes from an article published by Udemy called The Portrait of a Pandemic at Work. The idea was to understand how people's concerns about well-being and job insecurity was affecting their day-to-day working life. In case you're interested about the full report, I've added the link to the description. So the question is, can I replicate this chart in Excel? Can Excel do it? Can I do it? Let's give it a try. First thing I did was to type out the data in this sheet. Next thing, I'm just going to insert a clustered column chart to get these two bars in there. So let's just highlight the data set, go to insert charts, clustered column chart. That's the first option we have under 2D column. Okay, so far, so good. Now, how do we get the bars that are in the background? My idea is to add two more series to this that go all the way to the end. Now I could do something like 100% or one, anything that would be then on a secondary axis and not beside the other bars. This means I have to add two more series to this. I'll call the first one full one and full two. One and two. Now I'll put 100% for these. You can put a one as well. It doesn't really matter what number because they're going to be on a separate axis and we're going to fix the minimum and maximum of that axis. To bring the new series in, click on the outside border of the chart and just expand the area. Now they're automatically added as separate bars in our chart, and because it's 100%, it's just showing as a one here. So let's put these on the secondary axis. I'm going to press Control 1 to bring up the series options. You can also double click on a series to bring up the options here. Let's switch to the secondary axis. Now, this doesn't look really great because it's covering the values in the primary axis. If I repeat for the other one as well, look at this. It's covering the ones before. Now, because it's on a separate axis, it doesn't really matter what the order of my series is. So check this out. If I right mouse click and go to select data, and I bring these up so that they should be behind these should actually be on top of them, and I click on OK, nothing changes because they're in a separate axis. So I'm just going to press Control Z to go back. So the other way of tackling this is to actually put the series that's connected to the primary, which is our main series here, on the secondary axis of our chart, because this way they're going to be in front of this full series. So let's put these back to primary and try the other way around. Right, with charts you can play around to get the effect that you want, and I encourage you to do that because every time you're going to find something new in there. So this time let's put the yes series on the secondary axis and see what happens. Now just a reminder, in case you aren't subscribed to this channel, think about subscribing. Okay, so now let's put this on the secondary axis, and the no series, which is this one, I'm also going to put on the secondary axis. Take a look at this. They are now in front. We're getting close to the final image. The primary series here is actually my full series, which is now in the back. But take a look at the axis. It goes all the way to 120. I want to fix this to 100% because I want them to go all the way to the end of the chart. So I'm going to select the axis, go to axis options here. And for minimum, I'm going to type a 0 and press enter just so that this turns from auto to reset. This way I know that I've fixed this manually and it's not going to change. The maximum is 1. Now this looks a lot better. We have to adjust the colors, which we'll do in a second. The axis in general is something I want to hide. We don't see that in the final image either. So just select an axis, go back to axis options here, but this time to labels. Instead of next to axis for label position, select none. Same thing for the other one. None for label position. We can remove the grid lines now. Let's adjust this color. I so wish Excel had a color picker like in PowerPoint that we could just go and click on the color that we want to replicate and adjust our series colors like that. But unfortunately, it doesn't. So I'm going to use PowerPoint to figure out what color we have in the background and what color we have for this no series. The yes series, I'll just go with a dark color. I think it's easy to guess that one. Let's go with this dark blue grayish color. That looks quite good. To get the other colors, I'm going to copy this, open up PowerPoint, a blank presentation. Let's remove this and paste our image in there. Okay, so to see what colors we have, insert any shape that you want and adjust the shape fill to one of the colors. I'm going to use the eyedropper here. Click on the no series to get the right color. Now to pick up the gray color in the back, let's use the outline. So for shape outline, eyedropper, and select the gray series. Okay, so we have both. Now what is the color code associated to each one? Go back to shape fill, to more fill colors. Under custom, I can copy the hex code. Now you can also use the RGB code. So I just copied this to the clipboard, click on OK, shape outline, same thing, more outline colors, copy and add this to the clipboard. Okay, now let's go back to our Excel file, click on the background color, go to fill options, more colors, under custom, paste in the color code I just copied and OK. Repeat for the other one. It's already there, so I just have to select it. For the no series, that was the second color I copied to the clipboard. So let's go back to more colors, custom, and bring up our clipboard, Windows V. That was the second color. Okay, and we have this. It looks pretty good. Notice the distance between the labels is different here. So let's adjust that on our chart as well. Select any of the series, go to series options under gap width. Let's reduce that. I'll try 100%. That looks good. We have to repeat for both the primary and secondary axis. Adjust to 100%. Let's add the data labels to our yes and no series. Right mouse click, add data labels. Right mouse click, add data labels. Adjust the labels, let's make them bold and a bit bigger. Same here, and also the font color of the label for the no series should be the same as the series. This looks pretty good. We can make this bold as well. Okay, so one thing we don't need is the full one and full two in the legend. So I'm going to select full one by itself, which means you have to click once. Let me click away to show you. You click once, you click again, and then you only select that specific legend and press delete. Click, click, and delete. Now we have yes and no in there separately. So we have successfully replicated this chart in here. Now you can add as many titles as you want if you use a text box instead of the chart title. So feel free whenever you want, remove the chart title and adjust your plot area. So give it enough room for your other titles. And then you can insert a text box by going to the insert tab, text box, and type out what you need. That's the full text here. Let's add a question mark. And then you can position this where you want. Now, ultimately, whatever text boxes and shapes you add to your chart, you can always group them together by selecting each of the objects, go to Shape Format, and group these together so that whenever you're moving your chart, everything comes with. There is one minor difference between our chart and the chart here, and that's the legend. Notice how the No series has the same color for the label as the series? We can adjust that as well. Just click and click again and update the font color from here. Now we can also make it bold to make it stand out. Now this fixes the color of the label, but the boxes here are longer. Now if you want it like that, you can also set this up. You can go ahead and insert a shape like a rectangle, make it the way you like and adjust the color so that it fits this image here. You can do the same for the Yes series, group your objects together and then bring them to the chart and group everything together. Now just remember, if you use this method, your series color is not going to be dynamic. So if you change the color of this, it's obviously not going to pull through, but you can get that effect if you want. Now all of this is dynamic. So if the overall value for Yes changes to 80, it's going to pull through to our chart. We have successfully replicated this chart. So that's how you can create these overlapping columns in your Excel chart. The lighter background bars give the chart a really neat look. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you like what you see on this channel, consider subscribing. And I'm going to see you in the next video.